Super Smash Bros. Melee Losers Finals.
Day of Champions 10, we have Armor Wolf and his Sick Link, and we've got Michael with his Samus. I was playing both of these guys earlier. I know Michael from way back in the Melee tournament days when I used to run them before Brawl came out. He's got a really good Samus. He's got a brother who plays a good Link. And Armor Wolf's Link, he reminds me of like Dr. Doom in Marvel 3. He throws out that boomerang, and no matter what you do later, it's going to hit you and knock you out of your stuff. So he's got excellent boomerang placement. Did you play him yourself?
I did, actually. He knocked me into Losers first in my first match, and then I met him just before Losers Finals, and he knocked me out again. It was exceptionally close, but he's just... I've never played a Link like that before. I really don't know how to deal with it.
This is actually the only match I think we've seen where we have two fairly heavy projectile-based characters. So, like, yeah. I mean, if we knew more about matchups, we could probably come it. But to be honest, we don't. So,
this is true. I mean, for my brother and I used to we have two primary matchups that we always played. It was his Fox versus my Falco, and his Samus versus my Link. And I gotta say, it was always a very uphill battle for my Link. Now that may be just because I was terrible with Link.
You see, Armor Wolf is he's jumping off the edge when Michael is recovering, and he's just like lightly dropping a bomb. If that bomb hits Samus's bombs for bomb jump, it'll mess up her timing and she might kill herself.
He's creating 2 points of attack every time. He always has either bombs or boomerang going.
Yeah.
He's always giving you something else to think about while he gets in.
Yeah, and Link as well, if people don't know, he can just crouch, and his neutral crouch stance has the Hylian shield out, and he can just block projectiles by
doing that.
He doesn't even need to use the guard button.
Yeah, and that's any projectile at all. Sam's charge shot just plinks off it.
So many things flying around. There's that boomerang now behind. Yeah, hit him. Sarah's saying it's like the Doom missiles into the bomb combo.
Yeah, I know exactly what you mean.
The only thing here worth noting is that Samus could technically catch some of Link's bombs in the air, but it's not worth the risk because you have to do the throw button, and if you do the throw button in the air with Samus, she does that grapple hook, and like whiffing that can leave you very vulnerable.
It's giving too much up for this one potential advantage you might get.
I'm not even sure like holding a bomb is especially worth for Samus. Oh, I fired the shot in the wrong way.
No, really. I mean, Samus has too much of her own stuff to worry about that anyway.
Yeah. So I see like Michael trying to drop bombs and kind of do similar with the boomerang what he's doing. The only problem is that the Samus's bombs aren't as persistent as the boomerang.
Yo, is this Brawl or what?
The main thing Link has to worry about is getting in on Samus, because Samus is a really floaty character, and if you can give her one good whack on high damage, she's going straight out. But
she is actually one of the heaviest characters in the game. So you'll hit her far, and she'll definitely float. She's a floaty character, but like the Varia suit that she's wearing makes her one of the heaviest in the game. So she dies at actually both her and Link, because of the weight of their equipment. They actually
Link's equipment is a huge factor in his weight, isn't it?
Yeah. So these guys are actually both quite heavy, reasonably floaty. Not a matchup I'm used to seeing very often. Oh, that's probably going to result in the kill if he can just keep. Oh no.
Yeah, he's been really, really good with those spin attack recoveries all day.
Like I'm not very good with Samus. I might try picking Samus in the grand final against Gory to see if I can scrub out a victory on a big level. But
isn't Samus his main?
Gory.
Yeah.
No, he plays Marth.
Okay.
Did you not see me losing 3 straight games?
Okay, so I must have been looking at the wrong screen whenever Gory was playing.
Oh,
then.
Probably. Yeah.
Fair enough.
But what I would like to do with Samus myself, like I'm not especially good with her, but I like to mix in. I like to fully charge the charge shot, and then mix in the homing missiles with the smash missiles. And then once they feel like you've got a rhythm down, try and nail them with the charge shot.
Exactly.
And you can tell if Samus has her shot charged, in case you don't know, by her flashing. As you can see, she's not flashing now. So
that's right. She'll have a sort of like a twinkle star just hanging around.
Exactly. Oh, very dangerous. So yeah, watch Link's drop bomb here. Yeah, he's doing it again. A bit early.
Those bomb jump recoveries are just incredible. I love watching him do that.
Yeah, they're really cool. I like seeing these two characters play, because you don't see a lot of people. Like, I don't think these guys are in the... I know Link, anyway, is like low tier. The Samus is probably like mid tier. But these aren't characters you see played very often.
Link is considered one of the worst in the games.
Yeah, he's pretty bad.
It's remarkable how his games are generally the most fight based out of most of Nintendo stuff, and yet anytime he's been in a fighting game, be it Smash Bros. Or Soul Calibur, he's terrible. He's absolute bottom of the barrel.
Yeah, I think he's one of the only characters that was like bottom tier in all 3 Smash games.
I think
he's actually the only one.
It's such a pity, because he's Link. He's my childhood. He is, and yet why does he have to be so bad? You'd think Nintendo would make him a little bit more balanced.
I don't think Nintendo.
But then
really.
Again, yeah, I take that back. Nintendo doesn't seem to know an awful lot about
like
balance,
basic human decency, and not eating children are things Nintendo needs to brush up on, in my opinion. I was big Nintendo fan, but the stuff surrounding Evo, it was a bit too much for me.
I was still genuinely amazed that Nintendo actually caved at the sheer amount of bitching that that came out after it was announced they were banning the stream of Smash Bros.
Yeah. Oh.
I was extremely grateful, but I was amazed that Nintendo actually gave in, because they're.
This is ten. We're still even on the first game, but Link has a one life stock lead.
Yeah, I've noticed that Alpha Wolf. Yeah, it is. Yeah. They tend to go on for quite a while. They're very very slow and deliberate and.
Oh, Armor Wolf. Sorry, yeah.
Armor Wolf. There you go.
I thought you were referencing a game developer.
Alpha Wolf. No, God no.
One thing that's interesting to watch here is I'm not terribly familiar what Link's actual kill moves are. I know the jump down in air, the sword plant is one, and the
sword plant is one.
Forward tilt is definitely one. But I want to see what move he tries to use to
kill
Samus.
His crouching A as well, which is the foot sweep. If he does that at tip range on the edge when they're trying to recover from underneath him, it spikes them straight downwards.
I thought that was Young Link. Suicide death.
Thing is, you can miss. You can
as most suicides are.
Okay. Losing my suicide is always very demoralizing.
So Michael now can change characters, which I know he won't do, or he can pick a different stage.
So he would go for. See, I don't personally think Link does well in stages with platforms. So, but then again,
ooh, Final Destination.
Well, here we go.
No Fox, lots of items. Final Destination.
Yeah. They get a free pass because they brought them themselves. They brought their own items.
But I'm very happy to see like this level of play here today, because we had 19 people entered into Smash Bros. Melee today. So, like, the most entered game was AE, then Smash, then I think Marvel, then Injustice. Wow! Did you see that missile? Oh my God! The model was pointed up, and the flamethrower was coming off.
There's the Doom missiles again, where he taps him in the front, and the boomerang just comes straight into him.
Yeah, like if we watch Armor's application of the boomerang now.
That's a death.
That's a kill.
Well, notice that they're playing. Both of their characters are unique in, well, except for Young Link, of course, because he's a clone of Link. But they both have the unique ability to. Yeah, they have a hookshot and a grapple beam for their throw attacks.
Yeah,
and
both of them.
For their recovery, if they air
nice
dodge,
combo.
They're still able to use their grapples to latch onto the stage and shoot back up. And in doing so, they reset their double jump as well. So they actually have really, really good recoveries.
Especially on this stage, they can grapple quite low down.
That's
and then
right,
use the momentum of the up jump to double jump back on the stage.
I need to work out what exactly is the box of the stage, because I look at that and I see, okay, which parts of those edges are actually physical and can be latched onto?
It's tough. It's a weird looking level.
That and Pokemon Stadium are the two most confusing ones.
Wow!
Jesus. Oh, see, look, there we go, right there.
That was a great. If I go down, I'm taking you with me, shot.
That was fantastic. That was but then again, he still had the grappling hook to spare.
Yeah, I feel like this stage definitely favors Samus, because all of her projectiles can go almost full screen. The charge shot definitely does. Nothing Link has can go that full screen without being charged up for a while.
Whereas Links are also they're not propelled. They're affected by gravity. So his bombs, his arrows, they will both fall in their path.
Yeah,
and boomerang, well, he can control the path, but it only goes a certain distance.
You can see exactly what I'm saying. He's always like throwing in a diagonal angle, so it kind of taunt! Oh my God! Disrespect!
You should see the grin on Mike's face as well. Look at that guy.
You're still one game down, Mike. Maybe save it for the after party.
Well, yeah, it clearly isn't over yet. I mean, that definitely cost him. So
I don't know. I'll tell him to my next game. I've been trying not to do it to be respectful, but I know the floodgates have opened now.
I'll see if I can hang on to the headphones and try and point it out as I'm watching.
Good neutral jump air from Samus. Oh, that could be a kill as well if he can hit another.
Oh,
yes.
God. Especially the Smash missiles that have so much knockback on
them.
That's
so good for juggling off stage.
And if he doesn't, and if he wants to, you can trade off some of the knockback for, tracking him. Because they have the Norm missiles are homing missiles as well.
Yeah, the homing missiles do very little damage, very little knockback. They're more suited for like harrying. Like,
absolutely,
a lot closer to like the Mario and the Dr. Mario projectiles. Just kind of annoying, but they won't get you a kill.
But if you have your opponent trying to recover upwards towards the edge of the stage, they can definitely pose an obstacle.
I think that was one of the first throw exchanges we've ever seen. The two guys are kind of hesitant. Oh. been hesitant to go for throws so far, commentator's curse, just because of the big recovery.
Especially when I was playing Wolf earlier, he never once used his hookshot, and that's because it's so unsafe.
Yeah, Samus is too. I think they're almost identical with like statistics for, you know, the range and the
just the sheer. It's just the way it's illustrated as well. If he fires and misses, then the chain just goes limp and hits the ground.
Up and B kill.
It's really.
That was probably the other kill move I was wondering about that we didn't see, up and B. And you can
up and B is a great, it's a great one from underneath, yeah.
You can see as well that Amulf is sort of adapting his recovery style. He's letting himself fall below Final Destination and he's creeping up along the edges so he doesn't have to deal with the smash misses.
Oh. A little bit more charge would have killed him,
Very good. Just timed his invincibility perfectly.
He's just assaulting him with obstacles.
Oh, it's next hit on Link is probably going to do it. And next hit, maybe after this hit.
It's good recovery. Okay,
yeah,
so
he can. He's
close now.
Oh, there we go. Oh, he's going for the style finish.
Oh, edge guarding, so dirty and yet so effective.
I thought we were going to see a completely unnecessary style spike there, but he just went for the safe edge guard, which I suppose is good. I've already completely suicided off the level in one of my tournament games, so I don't want to see other people doing it. And we're back on Battlefield.
Right. So this is decided.
This is the final game.
Got completely silent. It's so tense.
Yeah, sorry. I got to remember to commentate this. So this negates a lot of Samus's advantages because she can't alter the vertical trajectory of her projectiles as well as
absolutely. Well,
Lincoln, she can fire a charge shot straight ahead, a smash missile straight
ahead. Oh, did you see that?
Wow. What move is that? That hit?
That's her crouching A, and it's
yeah, crouching A is the explosion.
Crouching A is the explosion. She just poof.
I thought that sent people up. I'm not quite sure what happened.
Yeah, but he was hanging off the edge. So if it connects while they're hanging off the edge or they're in the air, it's a downward spike.
Okay, that's interesting.
So
On this level, like Link's projectiles are a lot more useful than Samus's because he can throw bombs up or down. He can let them drop. He can curve the boomerang up. So
and the three platforms give him nice vantage points to do so from. So he can actually hop onto the platform and then lob a boomerang down.
Like we were saying in the other match, like he can't just like tap A to throw a projectile easily against her on Final Destination. But here he can because the arrows are affected by gravity, so they'll fall down. Oh, good.
You know, it's a dungeon crawler versus a space warrior, so it makes sense that one's affected by gravity and the other isn't.
We saw a little bit of wave dashing there from Link after the kill.
That's one thing that has been inherently absent from today. I mean, there was one person that was meant to come along today.
Gory can wave dash. He was doing it in our matches. I don't think anybody else here can.
I literally didn't get I didn't. He was so good at Wolf. Sorry, is just so good at. I just falling the maximum distance possible and then recovering up to with the spin attack.
Yeah, that's good. That's something you can really only do if you like you main your character and you know exactly what kind of vertical height you have.
My strongest game with Falco is his meteors, especially his down A meteor in the air.
Yeah.
But I had so much trouble trying to launch that on Link when he was spinning upwards. It was just I couldn't get anywhere.
But
there we go.
The big strength that Gory Snake has, if you watch him play, is that he basically has the best movement here, and that goes a long way in a game that's basically a 2D platformer.
Absolutely.
So that's the most impressive thing to watch if you see Gory play later, because he is in grand finals, and one of the three people here is going to have to claw their way through to get to him.
I heard he was like when Smash was actually played, he used to come second in pretty much every tournament in Ireland.
I used to run the Smash scene. I only ran two tournaments. Brawl kind of killed it, but yeah, he did come second in each of those two tournaments. Yeah, I came third in the first one, and I think I might have to DC myself from the second one because I had to like help someone get back to a train station. So
the less said about Brawl today, the better.
That's good enough. We'll see now. We're getting very even damage, very even stock, very even match overall.
Whereas last time it was very, very clearly in Samus's favor. Just Samus still has the raw damage from her melee attacks and the smashes on her projectiles and her missiles.
Yeah.
But Link has the advantage now that he's actually able to assault her from so many different directions.
Bounce the boomerang off the level and hit
Samus.
Yeah,
you can
do
that.
That was lovely. I really like to see that.
I think that's probably one of Link's best neutral air attacks. It's literally just neutral jump kick.
So his best neutral air attack is his only neutral air attack.
Well, when I say neutral, I mean not up or down. Yeah, but he has his two sidekicks, but
his forward in the air I think has good kill potential. His back one not so much.
It does, but it takes a lot of wind up on it, so you really have to time it properly. And his back one is a double kick, and that is it's rarely worth using except when you have to, just because.
So advantage here, Michael. He's got one stock lead, and he's got the charge shot. So unconventional.
And suddenly it's even again. Yes. I mean, one smash would have you could have one good hit would have evened it out, but he could have earned a bit of damage. Just defended it for a little while.
I'm not quite sure what he's doing. Link wasn't near him. It looks like he tried to spike the level, and maybe he was trying to do like a neutral air fast fall. But it was very, very. It's probably the tensest match I've seen.
You should have seen some of mine.
They're going for the safe moves without a lot of recovery. Oof. And of course, Samus is, because of directional influence, if Samus gets hit when she's doing her down A, she won't get sent quite as far.
That's right.
With her already existing heavy weight, that's a good move to be going for.
That's right. If you're hit while during crouch, it greatly lessens the knockback. And,
If any of us were any good, when we saw ourselves getting hit, we would instantly react and press in a direction, but we're not. So if we're already holding crouch, it just kind of works out for us because we're holding down when we get hit.
Just planting yourself in front of them and mashing A is a very sound strategy. So
I think he got knocked out of a charge, so he ended up shooting an uncharged shot there.
Yeah, so he's that's right.
Very close game.
I don't know if he has any charge, but he definitely hasn't got a full one. So
neutral air, and the charge shot's coming out, dodging. Very good evasion there. Spiking up neutral.
That's it.
And next hit is probably going to do it on either guy.
Okay, got him near the edge.
So he's throwing out his Doom missiles, coming back. A minute and a half left. I don't imagine this is going to go.
Just barely. He still had the inertia carrying him over.
Michael, excellent game. Fantastic. I love seeing those two characters play. Well done, lads.
So that was loser. So Michael is out and Wolf advances.
Yes.
Okay,
I think to me, so I'm going to get off the mic.
All right.